Hello everyone, I'm Rashmi Mangla. I'm working as an assistant professor for St. Andrews Institute of Technology and Management for the BBA department. Today we'll be studying human resource management. Now the topic which I'll be covering today is introduction to HRM. The key points which we'll be covering mainly are: what is HR, that is human resource; what is human resource management; nature of human resource management; scope of human resource management; and functions of human resource management. Now, when we talk about what is HR, basically, you know, human resource. Human resource basically deals with all, in an organization, all the people who are working for an organization, they all comprise of human resource. As we can see here, human resource is a set of individuals who make up the workforce of an organization, business sector, or an economy. Now, apart from the term human resource, there are some other terms which we can use to depict for the people who are working in our organization, you know. For example, we have manpower, talent, labor, or we can simply call them people. Now, next is, what is HRM? That is human resource management. Now, when we talk about the term human resource management, you know, basically, human resource management may be defined as the total knowledge, skill, creative abilities, talents, and aptitudes of an organization's workforce. And apart from all that, we also, you know, they also include the value, attitude, approaches, and beliefs of the individuals who all are involved in the affairs of the organization. See, if we talk about it in brief, basically HRM is the process of acquiring, training, appraising, and compensating employees and of attending to their labor relations, health and safety, and fairness concerns. A management function then helps managers recruit, select, train, and develop members for an organization. Then HRM may be basically defined as a set of policies, practices, and programs which are designed to maximize both personal and organizational goals. So basically, human resource management works on the personal goals of the people as well as on the organizational goals of the given organization. All right. Now, next we move on to nature of HRM. Now, when we talk about nature of HRM, all right, so there are, we can also call it as features of HRM. Now, firstly, HRM is a science as well as an art. Now, when we talk about science and art, basically, HRM is a very complex topic. HRM is both art of managing people by recourse to creative and innovative approaches, as well as it is science. Why? Because of the precision and rigorous application of the theory that is required in it. So that's why we can say that HRM is both art as well as science. Then, secondly, HRM is a pervasive function. Now, when we talk about pervasive function, it basically means that it is required in all the departments of the organization. So, it is pervasive because it is required in every department of the organization. All kind of organizations, be it profit or non-profit making, have to follow the concept of human resource management. And development of HRM covers all level and all categories of people and management and operational staff. There is no discrimination that is made between any level or categories of people. All right. Then next one is, it is a continuous process. Now, when we talk about continuous process, firstly, it is a process as there are a number of functions that are to be performed in a series, which basically begin with human resource planning, then to recruitment, then selection, training, performance appraisal. Now, but to be specific, the human resource management process includes acquisition, that involves HR planning, recruitment, selection, placement, socialization. That is all a part of acquisition. Then we have development. Development includes training and development and career development, both the things. Then we have utilization. That is, how do we utilize? By job designing, motivation, performance appraisal, or reward management. And maintenance. Now, maintenance talks about labor relations, employee discipline, grievance handling, welfare, termination, etc. And now, these are the processes that are involved in HRM. Now, it is a continuous process because it is never ending. You know, we have to just go on. Like if one employee leaves the organization, again the same process starts in order to hire a new one. So it is a continuous process which keeps going on. Next one, it is interdisciplinary. Now, it is, you know, basically encompassing welfare, manpower, personal management, which keeps close association with employee and industry relations. It is kind of multidisciplinary activity which utilizes knowledge and inputs from psychology, sociology, economics, etc. It is changing itself in accordance with the changing environment. As and when the environment changes, you know, so the HRM techniques also keep on changing along with the changing environment. Now, it has basically, you know, it has traveled quite a long parameters. It has traveled from exploitation of workers to treating them as equal partners in the task. You know, the techniques which were used quite years ago, those are not the ones which are being used now. So, as you know, along with time, they keep on changing the techniques. Then, next is focus on results. Now, basically HRM is performance oriented. It focuses mainly on results other than on rules. It encourages people to give their 100% result. You know, HRM basically has the task to motivate their employees. It tries to secure the best from people by winning the wholehearted cooperation. It is a process of bringing people and organization together. Why we have to bring them together? So that our goals are met. Goals of whom? Both organization goals and the individual goals of the workers also. Then next is people oriented, or we can also say people centered. Now HRM is mainly about people at work, both as individuals and as group. It tries to help employees to develop their potential fully. You know, it's mainly people centered. It is mainly made for motivating the employees who are working in our organization. It comprises people related functions. What kind of functions? For example, hiring, training and development, performance appraisal, working environment, etc. Then it also has the responsibility of building human capital. People, again, they are a vital, you know, for achieving organizational goals. If we do not have the man force, if we do not have the, you know, the people who are working for us, without them, our organization is incomplete. Our task cannot be done. So organizational performance depends on the quality of people who are working in the organization and employees who are working there. Basically, they mean the same. Then if we talk about the next one, it is based on human relations. Now, when we talk about based on human relations, again, it's somewhat simple. You know, it's somewhat like people oriented only. It's interconnected kind of. Basically, HRM is what? It is a philosophy and a basic assumption that employees are human beings. So we have to consider employees as human beings and not as a factor of production. Factor of production can be land or labor or capital. They are. But in spite of being a labor, they are also a human being. So when we talk about human resource management, we consider our laborers as human beings and treat them the same way, apart from the fact that they are also a factor of production. Now, HRM recognizes individuality and individual differences. So every manager, in order to be successful, must possess social skills to manage people with different needs. Basically, he should have the skills so that he can tackle the problems, whichever his, you know, the people are working in the organization. If they come up to the manager with any sort of problem, the manager should possess the special skills to tackle with all of them. If he doesn't have that, then he cannot keep his workforce happy. The next one, it is an integrated concept. HRM in its scope includes personal aspect, welfare aspect, industrial relations aspect in itself. So, you know, it is an integrated concept. It considers many more aspects, which we'll be learning in the next slide also when we'll be learning about scope. Personal aspect mainly includes, I'll just tell you in brief here because we're going to learn in detail in the next slide. Personal aspects covers all the process, which include like planning, recruitment, selection, placement, etc. When we talk about welfare aspect, it deals with the facilities which are provided to the people who are working in the organization. Industrial relations again tells us that maintaining cordial relations with the union members. All right. Now, it is also integrated because it is concerned with not only acquisition. Now, as I told you, acquisition involves all those processes like hiring, selection, training and all that. So, it does not only involve acquisition, but it also involves development, utilization, maintenance. So, it has a huge scope. Now, last but not the least, basic to all functional areas. Human resource management is a basis which has to be followed in all functional areas, whether it is kind of any type of organization. HRM has to be followed in all the organizations. Alright? So, without keeping our human resource, our employees happy, the organization cannot prosper. So, this is a technique which has to be followed. Now, next we move on to scope of HRM. Now, when we talk about scope of HRM, as I was telling you in the previous one, we deal with these four main key points. Personal aspect, which also means human resource planning. Welfare aspect, industrial relations aspect, and performance appraisal. Now, if I tell you about the first one, that is the personal aspect, when I told you. You know, personal aspect includes manpower planning, recruitment, selection, placement, transfer, promotion, training and development, retrenchment and layoff, etc. It includes all the processes. So basically, human resource planning is what? It is a process by which the company has to identify the number of jobs vacant, whether the company has excess staff or shortage of staff. And whatever is there, like if there is an excess, then also they have to deal with it. And if there is a shortage, then also they have to deal with it. So this entire concept comes under personal aspect, all right? Then second is welfare aspect. Human resource management also deals with the welfare of its employees. Now, welfare includes what? It includes all the working conditions where they are working, the amenities which are provided to them. Now, what all things are included in amenities? For example, canteen, crutches, rest, lunchrooms, housing, transport, medical assistance, health and safety, recreation facilities, etc. They all comprise of their welfare aspect. Then if we talk about industrial relations aspect. Now, again, human resource management is another, you know, it's a major important area is maintaining coordinated relations with the union members. And why do we need to maintain it? Why? Because this will help the organization to prevent strikes and lockouts and ensure smooth working in the company. If we have good relations with the union members, then they will, you know, the chances of going on strike or having lockouts in the organization will reduce. This also covers union management relations, joint consultation, collective bargaining, grievance and disciplinary procedures, settlement of disputes, etc. All these aspects are covered under industrial relations aspect. Then the last one is performance appraisal. Of course, this is the most important one we can talk about for all the people who are working in any of the organization. Everybody, you know, everybody looks after their performance appraisal. For example, if an employee has been working in an organization for an year, so at the end of 1 year, his performance will be first, you know, it will be measured for the entire, like on the basis of certain ratings or on the basis of certain scales or parameters, the performance is measured. And on the basis of their performance, they are given an appraisal, all right? And that goes on year to year. And on the basis of these appraisals only, in future, they might get promotions or incentives or increments in salary. Then, if I move on to next one, with this, we are done with today's content. Now, what you have to do is, you just have to try to write down the answers for these questions yourself. First one, what do you mean by human resource management? Describe the nature of HRM. What is the scope of HRM? You have to explain it in brief. I've already given you the explanations. I hope you've jotted down the points. If not, you can review the video and please jot down the points so that you're able to answer these questions. Apart from that, if any of the children still have any query, we can connect on Google Meet. Thank you for today.